Is it a moral act or is it immoral act?
Well, in the context of me putting myself in her shoes, she believes that that is fine for her.
No, but I'm just saying, as a society, should a society accept that as a moral action or as an immoral action? Should it be legal or should it be illegal?
Well, in the context of what you're giving me, you're giving me the protocol that
she's willingly doing it. I'm saying willing, because you said in the beginning, I'm not saying that anyone, I'm just asking you, a woman in Ethiopia willingly, from her own volition and her own autonomous decision-making capabilities,
in her culture,
decides, because of cultural reasons, so that she wants to remove the entire clitoris. I am saying, from a Muslim perspective, that's not right, yeah? Now, I'm saying, why is that not right? Because actually the Prophet said, that's not right. He told us.
Yes.
Now,
so okay, hold on. What you're having here is, that's you.
I'm just asking, do you agree with me or do you disagree with me?
No, I can't give a simple answer, because what you're trying to do is you're trying to make me a Muslim to give your answer.
No, I don't want to make you a Muslim.
But what I'm saying is that from your point of view, you're saying it's wrong. But from her point of view, because if that's her culture and because that's the way her culture wants to be, and because she wants to fit into her culture.
So is that okay for you, sir? FGM.
I'm not saying it's okay for me. I'm saying from your point of view, it's not okay. From her point of view, it is okay. From my point of view, it's a very difficult decision for me to make, because obviously I can understand that that's her culture.
Let me ask you another
question. I don't even know whether that's her culture. That's just the ethos you're giving to me.
No problem. The sociological statistics that detail FGM and MGM.
I believe also. Just let me say one other
go
thing.
On.
I believe that because I've changed it from one thing to another.
Yes.
If a woman is taking out her vagina and not putting a penis.
Not by vagina, just a clitoris.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Because there's the labia and there's other parts. Which she does say she does it just the clitoris.
Okay. Well, for example, if it's just the clitoris, that means that she's just taking away the bit that has sensation. So maybe for her, that means that she doesn't want to be sexual, whereas for you, maybe, even though from a Muslim point of view, maybe you do like to have sex with your wife, but on the other hand, maybe other people don't want to have sex. So this is a very difficult thing as well.
Okay.
Because taking away the clitoris means that you're taking away a part of the sensation of being able to have an orgasm. So maybe if she doesn't want to have that and her culture doesn't want her to have that, and if she doesn't
want to. So FGM is okay in that context?
I'm not saying it's okay, but I'm using your arguments of.
I'm not making arguments.
A Muslim trying to impress your view on something
else. I'm not trying to impress anyone's view. I'm just saying. Because this is a question that's
often. Well, why are you posing the question to me and putting me? I mean, I'm fine to be put into a box,
hold on.
Because I've done this myself. I'm not in that cultural realm.
Okay.
And I'm happy to answer your question.
Let me ask you a question, right? The statistics that detail the amount of times FGM is done in a particular place or MGM, they don't detail basically a man changing into a woman and a woman changing into a man. However, if you look at the definition according to the World Health Organization, the NHS, it doesn't stipulate in the definition of the World Health Organization that the person had to be willing or not willing. In other words, if a woman decides to do a clitoridectomy and take her whole vagina away, then that becomes, or even the labia, and there's other, even if she has a piercing there, according to the World Health Organization, that becomes FGM. Now my question is, because as Muslims, we're always asked these questions. It's my time today, to be honest with you, in this blunt way I'm going to tell you, to ask the questions. Because if I'm saying to you right now, why are not, for example, people like yourself counted in the statistics? Because what you've effectively done is you've done MGM, you've taken away the genitalia of the man, you've done it willingly, I'm not taking that away from you, you have done it willingly, but you've taken it away and you've morphed it into something else. Now what I'm saying is, from a sociological perspective, it's only fair if we include the Western world who decides to do that as part of a place or a hub or a hemisphere which actually practices MGM and FGM.
Okay,
do you agree or disagree?
Let me try to understand your thing, because we need to go slowly here, because maybe your education or the questions you're answering, I need to understand. So for me, when I transitioned,
yes,
basically I've now got a birth certificate and everything else, which has changed from being who I was before to who I am now. So the question, I just want to understand your question as regards, been changed from a male to a female, and in the statistics, in law, I am now Naomi, I'm now female. So in the context of this country, I have now gone from the statistic or whatever you're saying, male, the world female. Organization of being who I was before.
To what you are now.
Who was a raped, whatever, to now be Naomi, who is more comfortable in my skin.
I'm not even challenging that.
And to
At this moment, I'm not even challenging that.
And to add on to another bit, to make it more personal to me, because your question, I want to understand.
I'm not trying to challenge your experience. I don't want you to strawman the argument. Because what I'm saying here is that, just because you asked me a question.
Yeah, but let me speak.
If you don't mind me speaking. Go ahead.
I'm also just going to say that from my, because you may want to pick this up as well, and I'm quite happy for you to do so.
Yeah.
From my own personal point of view, because I was raped, I've had what's known as a labioplasty. There's two different sex changes, a vaginoplasty and a labioplasty. Vaginoplasty just basically means that if somebody has a vaginoplasty, it means that when they go from male to female, in other words, have the vagina, it means a man can do his business. What I decided was, because I was raped and because I had lots of difficulties with being a raped homosexual and ending up doing addiction to cover up my pain of rape, I chose the labioplasty, which means I don't want a man's whatever in my thing.
Okay.
So from your point of view, the only reason I'm saying all of that
is
because you may have an issue with the fact that I've... You were having,
I'm
you
not having, even saying I have an
you
issue
having
with
issues with about people taking away their clitoris or whatever.
Yeah, I have an issue with that.
Now, basically, I've got the clitoris, but I don't have a feeling, because when you have a sex change, you may not have
Naomi,
feelings.
Naomi, if you don't mind, I don't want to take away anything from your personal experience. I'm not here to judge you on your personal self. Your experience, you have absolute autonomy of your own experiences. I'm not here to challenge you on that. I'm here talking about something sociological, something societal. Do you understand? Okay. Because basically we have to understand that when we do sociology and when the public are told something, okay, when the British public or the Western public are told, for example, look, Muslims are forcing X person, Y person, Z person to do FGM. And what is FGM? They define it as basically the removal of the clitoris or even less than that. But at the same time, they allow, for example, a kind of clitoridectomy to happen under the guise of another culture, which is Western liberalism. I personally believe, even if you do say, okay, it's not being done willingly or unwillingly, because we covered that already. FGM, I would say it should be illegal, whether it's done willingly or unwillingly. If the woman comes forward, I'm saying to you, it should be a fair standard. You should have, in the sociological statistics, I wonder where the West would rank. I wonder where the West would rank if you put all of the sex changes that have been done, men to women, women to men, on the sociological ladder. Because if you do, I promise you, the West will not be on the bottom, and Ethiopia will not be necessarily always on the top. It might be the case that the West has more FGM and MGM cases than it wants to acknowledge. But I believe that based on that based on the way the method of basically allowing it for one culture and not allowing it for another culture, that is an unfair sociological comparison. Do you agree with me?
What we need to, what I need to clarify here, because you may have a more understanding of this than me, is you're talking about in the Muslim culture about FGM, and you're also talking about in another cultural paradise another type of FGM. So is it more popular in your culture or in the other culture you're talking about? Because I haven't looked into any of this. I've just had my own gender journey, and I haven't.
Talk about Muslim. I talked about Africa, by the way. I talked about East Africa, and I mentioned Ethiopia as an example.
So in Muslims, they don't do.
No, they do. Ethiopian. There's a lot of Ethiopian Muslims, Somalian Muslims, lots of Egyptian Muslims.
What I'm saying. Who have that done to them?
What?
Who have FGM?
Yeah, have FGM.
So if you're a Muslim, you can do FGM.
No, that's what I'm saying. Muslims do it.
Because I would think that's against your guard.
So the Prophet told us don't take away from it too much like that. He did actually tell us.
Because he wants you like the Christians. Let me speak for a little while.
Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Because I need to clarify. Because like the Muslims or the Christians, basically within that context, the Muslims and the Christians would be opposed, because God wants everybody to be either male or female, and you can't, even though we have people who have got penis and vagina, God created that.
To be honest with you, at the time of the Prophet, let me tell you something you didn't know, Let me actually tell you something you didn't know.
But
my
understanding of the Bible is that God created male and female, and God wants you to be in those two boxes. But we live in a world where people are not in those two boxes, so God and everybody else has to get used to it.
To be honest with you, right now, I'm not talking about that. That's not my point. My point is really a sociological case. All I'm saying is that if you're going to count as part of the sociological statistics...
So can you just FGM clarify, and MGM does just clarify in sociological, because I need to understand.
Okay.
Sociological meaning when, social as in social, who we are as people. Is that
yeah,
what you're talking
society,
about?
Yeah, in society. Basically, yeah. That's how society
so
interacts
with. Why should it matter about who people are? Why can't we just live together and,
no,
and,
no, no,
be,
no. I'm
and
just,
be whoever
okay, look,
we want to
this
be?
This is not my argument, please. That's something that, okay, that's away from what I'm talking about. I'm just saying that, I'm not sure if you've heard this, I'm not sure if you've been exposed to this. Muslims, because basically FGM, this whole thing of, and here I'm defining FGM in a narrow way. How am I defining it? Because it's actually defined broadly by the WHO. You know, according to WHO, having a piercing in your vagina, right? That is actually seen as FGM. Now, I wonder how many women in the West have piercings in the vagina. I promise you, it's going to be more than in the Middle East.
Well, in the Bible,
but anyways,
it says you can't have tattoos,
anyways,
my friend.
I'm,
so let's move
no,
away
no,
from these
I'm
arguments.
Just saying, I'm just saying, the point I'm making is, when for example, the West, the post-colonial West with its white jacket on, and telling all the rest of the world and its nations what to do and be and what to believe, all I'm saying is, okay, you want to put your white jacket on and tell us to be like yourself, let's see if you yourself are doing the right thing. Let's see if you yourself are sticking by the standards you're giving everyone else. So one of the things I have a problem with is that the West with a white jacket and telling everyone what to do, the white jacket meant to represent the white skin, and really this is a white superiority movement. This white West man telling, okay, look at these Africans, these barbaric Africans that you put them onto a, you know, a National Geographic newspaper. Look at those black people, look at those Africans, look at those Muslims, look what they're doing. They're doing FGM and MGM. But wait a minute. My point is, how do you define FGM? FGM is the removal of a part of a whole of a clitoris for cultural, political or religious reasons, yeah? If that is the WHO organization's definition, which has nothing to do with willingness or non-willingness, then in that case, you have to add into your sociological statistics the amount of people that are doing sex changes. Now, I'm not saying that, look, I'm not saying that, okay, my argument today isn't, okay, they shouldn't do a sex change. If you're a liberal and you're not confined to any religious program, do what you want. I'm not telling you to do anything in particular. If you're a liberal and you're not confined to any particular religious belief system, it doesn't matter what you do.
So, I mean, as a Muslim, your argument is it's fine for me to do whatever I want.
Hold on. I'm saying if you are
your guard would be disgusted about what you just said.
No, it wouldn't, because what I said is if you're a Muslim, a Muslim is someone who submits their will to God. Yeah. Now,
God wouldn't want you to be saying it's fine for me to do a sex change.
I didn't say it's fine. See, now you're, once again, I didn't say it's fine. I said, if you're not Muslim and you're not convinced of Islam, do you understand? This is what I'm saying. If you're not convinced of Islam, and our religion says, like Quran 15, there's no compulsion religion. So if someone like yourself, you're not convinced of Islam. All right, now you decided to do a sex change, do whatever you want to do in the West. I haven't got it's not my business what you do. Yeah, so I'm not saying that.
So
okay,
you don't care for other people other than yourself?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm here to actually convince people of Islam on one level, but on the other level, if they don't accept it, I can't force them to be Muslims. Do you understand? So from that perspective,
but your God, whether it be Christian or Muslim,
yeah,
teaches you to love people regardless of whoever they are, and therefore
we're careful people. That's why we talk to people like you.
What do you mean, people like me?
People
See,
that
that's
are non-Muslim.
Degrading.
No, that's not degrading. It's non-Muslims are basically. You said why don't you?
Kafirs. Yeah, I know what we are.
Yeah, and we are kuffar as well. Or other religions. Kuffar means disbelievers.
You call us kafirs, whereas
we're kafirs of other religions.
And whether it's Christian or that's Muslim, we're all going to hell unless you're Christian.
So now we're segueing away from the point. The point today I want to get to you. Sorry. The point I want to get to you today, yeah, the point I'm trying to actually make to you today is, look, there are certain standards that the West has made for the rest of the world. It's given to the rest of the world. It's telling Africans to live a certain way.
I think what you're trying to say, can I shortcut you?
Yes.
You're trying to say that the Western people, i.e. this country, is telling everybody else how to live their life, whereas poor Muslims can't say
no.
as much as the Western people. Is that what I'm trying to understand?
No,
is that what you're trying to say?
No.
Is that the level of your argument?
No.
That poor Muslims, because everybody else is dictating
to
you?
No, that's not the level of my argument. My argument is as follows. If the West can tell the rest what to do based on its culture,
but the West,
but
God is in control of everything. If you're saying that West is controlling, let God be the judge at the end of days.
Yeah, okay, that's what we believe in anyways.
Well, exactly. So what's your point?
My point is, listen, I
don't know if you're small enough to think that you're in superior or whatever, and that everybody else is superior to you, and poor Muslims because everybody else is small,
that's
is
not,
bigger
that's
than
not
you.
What I'm, that's not
but
what I'm
on the Day of Judgment, God will be the one who puts the superior into the minority and bring up the minority to be up to the heavenly standard, my friend.
Okay. I actually agree with you totally on that.
So the ones who are the poorest in life will become the richest.
Maybe,
and the ones
possibly,
who think their noses are too big and they don't even give to the poor will be the ones that...
Are you a Christian yourself?
No.
Okay, but I agree with what you just said. I mean, sounds right. On that note, I agree with you. I'm just making you think, all right? I'm not saying anything. At the time of the Prophet, by the way, let me tell you something that you didn't know.
Yeah, but how can you make me think? I'm trying to understand where you're going with these arguments.
Please.
You're talking to somebody who's
had
a sex change. I'm trying to work out where are you going as regards speaking to me, which is fine. I love the fact you're speaking to me because not many people have got the guts.
I wanted to discuss it. But look, another point I wanted to make to you is as follows, yeah?
But I personally, I'm trying to work out. I've already said that anybody who has this done to them against their will, that is totally wrong.
I'm not talking about against their will.
Or even with their will, but therefore if they're religious or if they're under a culture, they just, because you're giving me the picture where I've changed.
So is that okay?
You're giving me the picture where I've changed my penis into a vagina. You're giving me a picture where somebody does it in another country, where they're changing what God has given to them.
I'm saying that's wrong.
What God has given to them, or what creation has given to them, whichever theory you come from, and change their vagina, and don't create it to a penis, but create it to some other scenario. And you're asking me what I think about that. I personally find that a bit difficult, that somebody's taken their vagina as a female and turned it not into nothing because of their culture or whatever.
That's how you
find personally
it.
Find it difficult. But if that's what they've done because of their culture, then I have to submit or say that that is their will and that is their right,
you're
that is their choice, and you're having
you're
an
consistent.
Issue with that.
No, I'm not having an issue with that. I think you're right. You're consistent here, yeah? You're consistent. But the West is not like you. So the West...
So what does the West say?
When I say proponents of the West, which are, let's say, sometimes right-wing, sometimes Islamophobic, they will say in one breath that, okay, a person like yourself, he's had a sex change, that's absolutely fine, it's culturally acceptable, let's accept it. I'm not saying anything. That's the West. That's liberalism. It's in line with liberalism, okay?
Yeah,
agree.
And you're saying, as a Muslim, you don't agree with it.
No,
is that where you're coming from?
No,
is that what you're going to say? Because I think that's what you're going to say, even though you're struggling to say that you're against me. I'm happy for you to say you're
against
me. Against
you, okay. Let me tell you something. At the time of the Prophet Muhammad, there were people who had their penises basically castrated, yeah? And they lived aside the Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad did not treat them unkindly. Sometimes he would take care of them. So the point is really, it's not like what you're making it out to be. As Muslims, we're not here to go, oh, let me find this homosexual, let me find this transgender, let me find this guy, let me attack them. No.
Let me just hold on.
So please don't straw man the argument.
Yeah, okay.
I haven't said that to you. I haven't attacked you on your experiences. I haven't attacked you on your choice even. I haven't told you anything about what you've done. You put it up in a defensive mode. I'm talking to you about a very specific sociological reality. I'm just saying, on the one hand, the West defines, or the World Health Organization particularly, which is one of the most major institutions of the West, and it's not being rebuked or refuted by anyone, it defines FGM and MGM as the removal of genitalia. Okay, even partially or wholly. Having said that, it doesn't say anywhere in the definition of the WHO or otherwise that it has to be willingly or unwillingly. If a woman in Ethiopia willingly does FGM or herself, she'll be counted as one of those people on the sociological statistics. I'm saying, if you want to count her, if she willingly does it, why don't we count someone like yourself who willingly does it as well? It's absolutely the same, because if you're taking away your genitalia, then you're fulfilling exactly the textbook definition of the WHO organization. Now, if you don't like the definition, you should change the definition or reform it or ask them to reform it. You can put as part of the clause that it should be only if it's done unwillingly. But that's not what the WHO or the NHS or any of the major institutions have said. They haven't put as part of the clause that it's got to be willing or unwilling. They haven't made that distinction. If a woman now from Ethiopia goes out and she decides for her own cultural reason, I'm not saying it's a religious reason, because there's nothing in any religion, I don't think, that basically condones this. She decides to get rid of all of her clitoris, the whole of her clitoris, yeah? And her labia as well, yeah? And that's another thing. If she decides to do that, she would be counted by the sociological, by sociologists as someone who's performed FGM. Someone now goes from the Western world, decides to change from man to woman, woman to man, they're not counted. Is that fair?
Right, so we need to cover slight ground again. the purpose of the example you're giving, which is unlike mine, because I've chosen to go from one to the other, you're giving me an example of a woman who just takes away her parts, and I need to still try to understand the purpose in her culture of her doing this. So you're saying to me, she's doing it because she doesn't want to, well, she wants to take away her clitoris, which basically means to me she doesn't want sexual functioning. So are you
whatever,
saying...
Whatever she does, she has her or her, whatever, like she decides for whatever reason to get rid of her clitoris.
But how does she do that herself? Just chop...
No,
I mean,
not herself. She goes to
she
gets to a clinician, just like the way you did. She decides for whatever reason, she wants to get rid of the entirety of her clitoris.
Yeah, so...
Is that something you accept as a morally acceptable thing, or do you reject it?
So when you talk to me and you say she's doing that, can you please say that she's gone to a clinic? Because the way you...
Okay.
The way you talk...
She goes to a
clinic. The way you talk, it's like she's doing it herself, and that a bit difficult.
Someone else is there. Let's say they're trained. They decide to get rid of her clitoris for her.
So in these countries, they have gender clinics.
Well, they have. So the countries are many.
Because even in this country, country, London is one of the only ones, and people from all over Britain have to come to London.
I understand, but you're talking about some kind of what do you call it? Like when you make up, when you change the apparatus of basically to make it look like something else. We're talking about literally just chopping something, cutting something away, which can sometimes lead to little.
And for her husband, for example, when she does this, how does it make? The husband.
I don't care. I'm not here to defend this position. Do you get what I mean? I'm just saying that this happens. Yeah, let's say in the context of someone who does it safely as well. A woman goes to a gender clinic because she wants to and get rid of her clitoris safely. Yeah? Is that something which is counted as FGM? If so, why isn't also transgendered, what do you call it, operations, why are they not counted as FGM? If they both fulfill the same criteria according to the WHO.
Well, I've answered why the World Health Organization, as you call it, which could deal with all the health statistics, which I am aware of, but I don't know a lot about other things to do with the World Health. But I can't be accountable for what the World Health Organization does against the other organization you're saying. But yes, I agree with you that, like, if we lived in a world where it was fair, or if that's the right word, because obviously we don't live in a fair world necessarily, other than when we all go upstairs.
So we end up in agreement here.
But when we're down here, obviously, if we're living in a world where statistics are not counted properly,
yes,
where people are not being counted for being whoever they are, whether that's male, female, from normal purposes or unusual purposes, then obviously it's going to mean that the statistics are going to be unfair. And in your context of if somebody's doing it unfairly or again or with their will or against their will, then obviously that's also going to create unfair statistics.
Accepted. If FGM or MGM is counted as the removal of genitalia, if that's what it's counted as, whether it's done willingly or unwillingly, should transgendered operations, the like of which you've done, also be counted as FGM/MGM?
If you've done it willingly, then it's not abusive.
Okay.
The idea of if somebody's done it against their will or just taken off their parts for the purposes of satisfying their husband or their culture, I don't agree with that. But if
their culture, you just said culture, yeah?
Yes.
Satisfying their husband or their culture. But in Western culture, we know that it's acceptable for someone to change gender. So that's actually a cultural thing. But is it okay for the Western cultural paradigm to be accepted and the rest, or these backward, let's say, I'm not saying that, I'm not justifying them doing this, by the way. I'm saying it's wrong, yeah? Removing the whole clitoris in that way is wrong. But I'm just saying that the standard is not normal. It's not a normal standard.
Okay, so we need to go slowly again, please. Right. So we have a system where people are doing it because of culture and they're just cutting off their parts. I say that that is not right morally and also not right for my purposes. Obviously, I'm not the judge, but I believe that that's not right to do
it. Even if they willingly do it.
I believe if you're just cutting it off and you're not creating...
Willingly.
Even if you're doing it... If you were doing it willingly to become something else, I believe that's okay. But if you're doing it willingly to have nothing...
Yes.
Or if you're just being...
That's not fair. That's not fair. That's not fair. What you just said, that's not fair.
I'm saying...
That's not fair. Do you know why that's not fair?
I'm saying...
Because you're dictating the terms of liberalism. That's actually against liberalism. Liberalism is you do whatever you want so long as you don't harm anyone else. Which means if someone wants to get rid of their clitoris for whatever reason, maybe they wake up in the morning and they say, you know what, I don't like the way this looks. They want to get rid of it, yeah? That's their justification. But if it's for cultural reason, so long as they're doing it willingly, according to liberalism, FGM is actually an acceptable recourse.
That's what it is. It's not acceptable.
So you're saying it's okay. Well, I'm saying if this is if changing your gender is acceptable, then FGM willingly done is also acceptable. And if not, why not?
It's entirely different.
As I just said, we need to go slowly. Okay. I'm in a country where, as you've said, and you have, this is why I'm saying we need to try to educate each other and understand each other. In this country, it is legal if you choose to do it. Like, I've gone and I've chosen.
I'm not saying, by the way, I'm not attacking you.
I know you're not attacking me. Listen.
Okay.
So I've done it willingly and I've chosen to go and do it, and it's legal in this country.
Yeah.
You may disagree with it, but the fact it's legal and the fact I've chosen to do it and the fact that's the way I feel better, because I didn't want to be raped Brian anymore. So there were purposes and reasons other than gender dysphoria or male and female issues why
I've
done
this. By the way, I'm not attacking you or your personal like self and your story. I really, really leave that to you, yeah? I'm just talking very specifically about the issue of double standards.
Yeah, I know, but you can't talk to me and not expect you're talking to me who you know
has done it. Do you agree with me though?
I'm saying that in this country and in other places around Europe, it is legal to have a sex change. You're talking about countries where it is either illegal or people do it for other reasons other than feeling good about the reasons why they're doing it. That's my interpretation of what you're saying. For example, I've done it because I chose to do it. You're talking about examples where people are in countries where they're doing it for strange reasons. For me, I don't see a reason why a lovely girl should take away her vagina.
Someone could say the same thing about a man taking away his penis.
Yeah, but the man taking away his penis and becoming a woman is a different thing than a woman taking.
If they're both doing it willingly.
Okay, well, if they're both, as I said to you, that my feeling is a little bit double. On the one hand, if it's willing, then yes, I agree that if she's done it willingly and in her culture, then that is okay.
Anyway,
but then on the other hand, I have a slight issue with the fact she's done it and she's taken away her
parts. Okay, that's no problem. But look, I didn't want to attack you today. I told you that I'm Muslim. You didn't really want to talk about religion, so I discussed this with you. But here, I'm going to tell you that despite the fact that you've done what you've done to yourself, I mean, let me be straightforward with you, yeah? At the time of the Prophet Muhammad, people who had done the same thing as
you.
Now
you're probably going to be really religious and tell me I'm going to hell or something, yes.
Okay, well, you'll be surprised then, yeah? People that had done that, the same thing, like at that time there was castration methods, yeah? There were people who actually had done that, that had castrated themselves for whatever reason, like they had their own cultural reason for doing it at that time, at the time of the Prophet. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he treated them well, he spoke to them with kindness, he didn't treat them badly, he did, like, he spoke to them just as anyone. So here, I'm not trying to condemn you. I don't want you to take from what I'm speaking to you right now that I'm attacking you as a person. I'm not doing that, because that wouldn't be following the Prophet's Muhammad's example. These individuals, by the way, the scholars of Islam, they even debated, like, you know how women put on a headscarf? Some scholars debated, okay, should a woman wear a headscarf in front of these guys or not? Because, do you know what I mean? Some, we have discussions about this in Islamic jurisprudence. The point I'm making to you is simple, yeah? Is it's nothing to do with you, your decision, because you can take this. What you've done doesn't prevent you from being, let's say, a Muslim, if you wanted to. If you wanted to in the future, let's say, okay, I want to be a Muslim in the future. What you've done in terms of your thing, it doesn't prevent you from being a Muslim in the future. That's point one. Point two, I wasn't making an attack on you as a person. I know you've gone through some very tough things. If it was me, I don't know what I would have done. Do you know what I'm saying? That's number two. My friend, I'll talk to you in a second. Number three, I was just saying, generally, there's a double standard in terms of the way the West operates and the way it conceptualizes different practices. And I showed that by showing that, okay, if someone is willingly removing their clitoris or the labia, that would be classed as FGM. But if someone is willingly changing from male to female, female to male, that's not classed as FGM, although it entails exactly the same methods. I believe the debate on FGM therefore has to take a new shift. The debate on FGM has to take into consideration willingness and non-willingness, and it has to also be fair to the biological standard that is set for itself according to the WHO. That's my
okay, opinion. Can I say that I thought the purposes For my part, I thought the purposes of deliberately doing it or not, well, not deliberately, doing it unwillingly was against the law, and doing it willingly was not against the law. So I don't really, I agree with you that if somebody willingly wants to do it, then they should.
So really they should redefine FGM. The West has to now redefine FGM. So that it doesn't have, as part of its definition, people like yourself, yeah, being actually someone who's not FGM, MGM, but not counted as a statistics, it has to redefine it and include willingness and non-willingness. That's what it has to do. And if not, then it's a contradiction. And it's a false way of sociologically collating data and misrepresenting certain nations.
Are you saying that they put the people like me with the people who have had...
They don't class you as FGM or MGM. I'm saying that because in their definitions, willingness or non-willingness is not included, therefore they should.
Well, I thought the FGM was basically people who did it unwillingly, so that's how it's classed as mutilation. Whereas I haven't mutilated, I've done it willingly. Whereas if somebody does mutilate somebody in another country, chop off their whatever, like they used to crucify Jesus or do heinous crimes, then this is against the person's will. Therefore, that should be illegal.
Okay.
As regards,
okay. Let's define it that way.
As regards the claim or the scenario of you saying that somebody in Sudan right now, for example, is castrating themselves willingly, is a matter I would need to think about a bit more clearly. But for my purposes, definitely I have the right to have a sex change, and the person who is having that done to them, like Jesus did on the cross or whatever, or being castrated for horrible purposes, is obviously against the law, totally against the law.
We don't believe that Jesus was castrated. But anyways, thank you very much for talking to me. That's all I wanted to say, but thanks very much. I'm sorry if I came across as rude, yeah?
No, that's
I didn't mean to, I just wanted to basically flesh out a particular social issue, okay?
Yeah,
nothing to do with you,
I'd be
honestly.
Happy to speak to you again.